All right, here we are on the draw, and I think this hand is okay. A removal spell and five lands, basically. Cast an early Grave Titan. It should be okay. I really like hands that have a lot of lands in a deck like this because we generally have so many ways to use our mana. So, we'll lead off with Overgrown Tomb, I suppose. I have no idea what our opponent is up to. Feel like there aren't that many decks in Modern that actually play Arid Mesa, but there's still a pretty wide number. There are definitely not that many decks that play Sacred Foundry. I'm guessing blue, white, red. Yeah, looks like it. All right, well, our loam package ought to be really good against them. I think that's plan A. He also could be the more aggressive version that won the GP recently. Mana Leaking Sylvan Caryatid. That's fine. Yes, it's pretty bad if he has Geist then. But he does not, so that's good. Vendilion Click, on the other hand, we can totally handle. Alright, I will start criming. Is he gonna like think twice in response to this or something? Well, I have no idea what our opponent is casting in response to our Raven's Crime. He is mana leaking it. That doesn't really make any sense to me. You can always just discard mana leak to it. But let's go ahead and flash it back. Or retrace it, I should say. It's a little bit awkward that we have like Grave Titan that we want to cast, but I think if we just strip away his hand, then eventually we'll get where we need to be. This is going to be a Vendilion Click. That's fine. I think we'll just go ahead and disfigure that in response. We don't really want to path it. So he cycles away our Thoughtseize, and we drew a pretty bad card. Definitely would rather play lands at this point than Raven's Crime him with our hand being a 6 drop and a 7 drop. But really, what we want to do is just go ahead and draw one of those Life from the Looms. So we're getting clicked again. I don't think we want to path this in response. I think we would rather. If he draws us into lands, that's great. If he draws us into, like, gifts, that's even better. And worst case, we'll just play a Finx this turn. Okay, so we took away our Finx. Well, we'll play this Deathrite Shaman. That's actually quite good. It's probably going to die to a burn spell of some kind, but that's fine. So we could try to path this click. Yeah, I think that's worth doing now. He can counter it if he wants to. Okay, I guess he has Resto. That's annoying. feel like blue-white red decks don't typically play Restoration Angel these days anymore. So maybe I should have path during his upkeep. He also has made himself unable to cast Cryptic Command with the way his mana looks. Is he going to take away a card from me? He took Grave Titan. Well, it does get us closer to casting a Leshnorn at least. I'll find Temple Garden. Play this Tar Pit and pass, and the next turn we can cast a Leshnorn. Hopefully not get it mana leaked. I wish he only had one mana leak so he could just remove it with Deathrite. I feel reasonably confident that he has a mana leak in his hand. I guess we could crime him twice and then try and draw another land. I think I'm going to crime him at least once. Yeah, I think it's a safe bet that he does have a mana leak. Just because the fact that he, like, snap mana leaked a Sylvan Caryatid and then mana leaked a Raven's Crime makes me think it's pretty likely that he has something like that. Yeah, alright, well, we'll get his last card then. And hope to draw a land. It's probably Snapcaster. Yeah. Okay. So if we draw a land, we'll probably win, and if we don't, we'll probably lose. The path on the Vendilion Click really cost us a lot because it let his clock be so much more aggressive. Wall of Omens, okay. Colonnade doesn't actually do much. So we'll gain 2 life off of our Caryatid. And land, please. That's not a land, and we're dead. So, sideboarding, I think we want these hand disruption spells. I think that's really the only thing we want. And maybe we want to cut Finx. No, Finx is probably good. Maybe we cut Abrupt Decay. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense to me. If we leave in one, we can still gift for it if he has a Vendilion Click. But usually they don't have a lot of permanents that cost less than 3 mana that are targetable in this deck. Like, I don't really want to Abrupt Decay a Snapcaster.